under our feet. Peace within us, peace over us. Let all around us be peace.
The Jesuit poet Gerald Manley Hopkins wrote, "The world is charged with the grandeur of God." Perhaps in one of his many thoughtful moments, He had this profound sense of how this world in which we live and move and have our being flames out, shines like foil that is shaken against the light. And like the ooze of oil, this world gathers to a greatness. Like many of us, Gerald Manley Hopkins must have heard how the sheer gentle beauty of our world whispers of its creator's grandeur. Sadly, this home, which our God has created to be our very own, is now seared with trade, bleared, smeared with toil. While adorned with the colors and lushness that can be fashioned only by tender divine hands, our world now wears human smudge and shares human smell. The smudge and smell of all but barren soil, of bewildering abuse, of disease and pain and strife. Upon this dwelling place, generations have trod, leaving behind only footprints, but only because they have taken away with them nearly everything that desperate short human arms, tiny hands can grab at and stash away. It may be hard to believe, but it is true. God's grandeur still persists in all its gentleness. His grandeur still fills the world. It is never obliterated, never vanquished. Indeed, this is possible only because the Lord Himself lives in this dwelling place He has wonderfully and fearfully made. And because of this, there still lives the dearest freshness deep down thinks. God's beauty springs forth in the world. Like a patient father, like a comforting mother, our God warmly broods over us with warm breast and with bright wings.
Pagkatang tulong mo sa pinay, Because you will, it is kaibigan. Tantuin mo isang paglalakbay ang buhay sa ngasangang landas ay may ka hirapan kung ang lungkot o panganib sa'yo'y biglang tumalaw. O kung ikaw ay kayong mga napapagal aking pagiging hawain ng inyong pasanin ay aking pagaganin. Halina,
arise from your sleep.
Many thousands of years ago, before our Lord went back to the Father, He promised us that He would never leave us. He promised that He would be with us until the end of the age. And so we believe that the Lord is with us in spirit, here, now, and for always. However, haven't there been times in our lives when we actually felt His absence more intensely than we believed in His abiding presence? Haven't there been seasons on end when we actually sensed we were going through all this alone? And don't we sometimes feel that our Lord of wisdom and counsel seems to have locked Himself away behind divine silence? What we perceive as a divine withdrawal leaves us wondering when this dark cloud shall lift, when pain and discomfort will no longer pile upon each other. While such times last, we realize the power that despair wields upon us, so that we say, my God, why have you abandoned me? We are no strangers to suffering, and the sense of abandonment it brands painfully on our spirit. So when suffering and illness walk us to the edge of despair, this God with us, This Son of God who promised to stay with us till the end of time, He holds us. He reigns us in and binds us to hope. Yes, many times He does seem to bind us with such fragile threads of small comfort. Yet we do not dare cut Him loose and away. For Jesus, our Lord, no stranger to suffering Himself, is compassionate. So what is this silence all about? We wish to believe that this silence is a time when Emmanuel actually suffers with us and prays in us in words beyond all understanding.
Pagsapit ng gabing kulimlim, naririto ako. Papawiin ko ang lumbay mo. Kukumutan ka sa iyo, sa piling ko damhin mo ang mundo, sa kapwa mo muli mabibigo kapayapaan.
If I could touch you, I'd heal your broken palms if I could hold you in my arms. I'd call the soft breeze to caress your wearied arms. I'd call the moonbeam to dispel this darkest night. If I could touch you, I would. If I could hear you, your words of anguish, if you'll just whisper in my ear, the sadness weighing down your heart that no man sees. Would sing of flaming hope if I could hear you. I would,
Lord, have I waited for you to hear my cry. Lord, have I waited for you to answer my. Brethren, you do it for me.
Sing, sing. with my life, witnessing and giving, risking and forgiving. This is my song. I'll sing it with
love. Isn't it very strange how some songs written by complete strangers who lead completely different lives can nevertheless speak whatever you and I are unable to put into words? How then can music fashioned by another's hands become so one's own, whether one sings it or simply listens to it? When the Lord fashions a song in and through the heart of one person, the Lord inevitably plays that song not only through its fashioner, but in and through all who care enough to sing it and to listen to it. We are God's dwelling place. Our persons, our bodies, our spirits are home to God's song. We may be ravaged by the merciless trespass of disease, made febrile by abiding pain, seared and weakened by endless treatment, but even then, the Lord rests and finds comfort in us, His dwelling place. We may be hardened by failed relationships, shrunk down and shriveled up by wrong choices, made ugly by pain we inflict on ourselves and on others. But even then, the Lord rests and finds comfort in us, His dwelling place. And that gives us comfort. You have the Lord within you, and when you sing or listen to a beautiful song that speaks about you, it is the Lord. It is the Lord who finds His home in you. It is the Lord who sings His song to you to make it your own. And how lovely indeed is this dwelling place of His.
Other days anywhere if I
stand one day in your courts, belong to you alone.
My strength are you alone, my glory, my king.
Ang mga At magalak, walang hanggan, kanyang awa. Ito ang araw na ginawa ng Panginoon, tayo'y magsaya at magalak.
Kanang kamay ng Diyos sa aking mango, ang bisig niya sa akin ang tagapagtanggol. Ako'y hindi mapapahamak kailanman. Ipahahayag ko
proclaim his majesty. sa buong kalan.